A central organizing principle in DataViewer involves the use of trial variables. Trial variables in DataViewer usually come from your experimental script and are typically set up to code condition or independent variable information and information about any dependent measures that were collected in addition to the eye tracking data. For example, imagine an experiment in which on each trial, a participant was presented with either a black and white image or a color image, and was asked to press one key for black and white or another key for color. You would want a record, probably, of the color condition of each trial and of the participant's accuracy and reaction time in response to the image presentation. This information can be handled in DataViewer via the use of trial variables. Trial variables are central to DataViewer as they can be added to any output data reports that you create from DataViewer, allowing you to have all your experimental manipulation information and any behavioral data that you might need right there in your reports along with the iBase data. They're also really useful as they can be used to group your data, which can help for certain parts of the analysis process, including interest area creation and data visualization. If you program the experiment in Experiment Builder, then these trial variables will come from the data source columns and variable nodes that were in your Experiment Builder project. Experiment Builder, by default, will write the values of the data source columns and variable nodes to the EDF file at the end of each trial. If you program the experiment using a different programming environment, then these variables will come from any trial variable messages that your experiment sent to the EDF file. For more information on the formatting of those messages, you can check out the section of the DataViewer User Manual, Protocol for iLink Data to Viewer Integration, Trial Message Commands. If you want to check the values of your trial variables for the various participants and trials in your viewing session, you can use the Trial Variable Value Editor, which can be accessed from the Analysis menu. The rows of the Trial Variable Value Editor represent the trials of the viewing session, and the columns are the trial variables. You can also use this interface to edit the values of your trial variables if needed, either by typing them in or using copy-paste functions within the editor or from spreadsheet-based applications like Excel. If you need to add a new trial variable, you can use the Trial Variable Manager, which also can be accessed from the Analysis menu. You can click the New Variable button and then give your new variable a meaningful label. If you like, you can also give the variable a default value for the trials of the viewing session. Critically, trial variables can be used to regroup the data in the viewing session. By default, the data in the viewing session is organized by EDF file name, and you can see this organization in the Inspector under the Data tab. All the trials of a given EDF can be viewed by clicking the plus button next to an EDF file name to expand it. For certain steps in the analysis process, it can help to regroup the data in the viewing session so that instead of the data being organized by EDF file name, it is instead organized by the values of one or more trial variables. Doing so allows you to draw interest areas once per distinct trial in the viewing session and then apply those interest areas to similar trials within or across participants. Doing so also allows you to create data visualizations for all the trials with similar values of a trial variable, revealing differences in iData patterns across conditions or groups of participants. And finally, grouping the data can allow for the creation of certain aggregate output reports that are collapsed across conditions. To change the grouping of the data, you can go to the Edit menu and then click on Trial Grouping. From here, you can select which variables to use as grouping variables and use the arrow to move them to the Selected Variables box. You can group by as many variables as you like. I'll select a couple of variables here, which coded the condition of each trial and the accuracy of a button press response for the trial. After doing so, you'll see that the data in the Inspector are regrouped by the values of those variables. We'll discuss how these grouping variables can be used in interest area creation, visualizations, and time course reports in other videos in this tutorial series. So keep this ability to regroup trials in mind as being an important aspect of DataViewer usage as you become familiar with the software.